Expensive Firsties, before we get started with Judy Moody today, I have some exciting news. I'm sending you guys a little special something. So here's just some samples. Everyone's getting one though. There's something special inside, so be careful when you open the envelope so you don't want to rip them. There's also a little surprise inside just to make it more exciting, which you'll like. Your moms and dads might not be too crazy about it. So when you get your envelope and you get your letter from me, you might want to take it outside to open it, but still open it from the back. Don't tear it apart or you're going to rip the surprise inside. Okay, so I can't wait till you get these. Hopefully this weekend. I'm going to mail them out sometime today on Wednesday. All right, let's get started. You are going to get your book that you've been doing your book report with, and I heard some titles from some of the girls yesterday when we had our tea time party, which was so much fun, and boys will set something up for a funny Friday for you guys. But you're going to get your book report page, and we're going to fill out the next part of it after we read some Judy Moody. Now remember, she's still trying to stay in a good mood, so good readers predict what do you think's gonna happen next. So stop and make your prediction. And we visualize and create that picture in our mind, okay? So be thinking, wow, what does that look like in your head if you were telling the story and you had to like be the illustrator and draw it out? So this chapter's called Sour Balls. Okay, so we're gonna read part of it today and the rest of it on Thursday. Sour Balls. On GMD number 4, aka Friday, the finger knitting chain followed Judy out the door and down the sidewalk and all the way to the bus stop. Look, said Stink, you grew a tail. Judy turned to look. Sure enough, a tail of yarn snaked down the sidewalk behind her. Uh-oh, the end of my chain must have gotten caught on my backpack, said Judy. I gotta go back. Hurry up or you'll miss the bus, said Stink. Judy ran back to the house, gathering up the yarn chain as she went. She tossed the whole thing inside the front door just as Mom and Dad were leaving. The chain looped over Dad's shoe and around his ankle. Dad shook his foot free. Judy, Mom and I want to talk to you about this knitting. Late. Miss bus. Later. Bye, Judy called back. By the time Judy got back to the bus stop, her hair had escaped the bobby pins. She made two quick ponytails and asked, where's Rocky? You know he always gets a ride when it rains, said Stink. But it's not raining. It's gonna. I like when it rains. Rain means frogs. Can this day get any worse, she asked. What do you mean? Mom and Dad were having a knit fit, that's all. You're going to have to stop all that knitting stuff, aren't you, Stink said. Never. Uh-uh. I heard Mom and Dad talking. Don't pick a scab before it's time, Stink. Huh? Never mind, just tell me what they said. They said you're going to have to stop all that knitting stuff. They said it's taking over the whole house. No lie. No lie. All right, stop and predict. What do you think Judy's going to do? How do you think her GMD number 4 is going right now? Her hair fell out of his bobby pins. Rocky's not on the bus. And now she's just found out from Stink. Her mom and dad are going to say, no more knitting. All right, let's read on. Get that prediction. I can't stop now. I still have 3 more days to... I mean, if I stop now, I'll only have enough finger knitting to yarn bomb a birdhouse. Judy could feel a snit fit coming on. A no-knit snit fit. She felt like stomping, but she could not stop. She could not roar. She could not growl or even meow. It was only Friday. She had to keep up her good mood streak for 3 more days. That meant getting through one whole day of school without a string cheese incident or an interrupting chicken episode, without even thinking that Jessica Finch was a fink face. Otherwise, she'd be shivering in bunny boots and seeing sun dogs from her own personal iceberg in the back of the room. Frostbite City. But she made it this far, and Judy was determined. Now more than ever, not to go anywhere near Antarctica, not even close, not even New Zealand. She wiped the sour ball look off her face. She put on a big, fat, fake smile. She tried to sound smart and know-it-all like Jessica Finch. When life gives you lemons, Stink, make lemonade. That's what grown-ups were always saying. What? It's a saying, when life gives you sour balls, make sweet tarts. Huh? When bad stuff happens, try to... think of something good instead. Always look for the sweetness in the sour ball of life. You sound like a birthday card, said Stink. Mom and Dad might make me stop finger knitting, right? That puts me in a bad mood. But they said I could paint my room this weekend, and that's a good thing. All right, so she make a new prediction. She was able to turn her mood around, which was awesome, right? All right, she saw something bad, no more finger knitting, and went, oh wait, here's something good. I can paint my room. Get that picture in your mind. I'm still wondering what our room's gonna look like. How are you visualizing that? I remember we're working on book reports this week. I'm using Mood Martian for mine. So if you wanna grab your book, pause the video if you need to. And we're gonna go over what we have so far on our book report. So far you should have the title of your book report, mine's Judy Moody Mood Martian, the author, Megan McDonald. And now we're gonna rate in nonfiction, which is fact or fiction. And I know Ava said she was reading a frog book, so I bet you she's gonna write in nonfiction. And then I know that Kira, Kiara, and Cora, from what we talked about yesterday, are going to write in fiction. Remember, fiction has characters, and it's made up. Could happen in real life, but it's not all true facts. So if your book is like Ava's and it's a frog book, you're gonna write nonfiction. If it's like some of the other girls who had tea time with me yesterday, you're gonna write fiction. Then tomorrow we'll come back and do characters. Don't worry if your book is nonfiction, because the topic of your book will end up being your characters, okay? So we can work that out tomorrow. So make sure you're reading your book and filling in this part of your book report for today, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, firsties.